Welcome to BSc Statistics students. So in this lesson, I discuss test for a single mean. It is one of the large sample tests. I am discussing large sample test for a single mean. That is based on one sample. If you conduct the test procedure for means, that is nothing but test for single mean. For example, from the population, for example, you have drawn x1, x2, and so on, xn. These are the sample observations. That is, this is a sample which is drawn from the population of size n. This is what indicates. This indicates the sample size n. Okay, it is drawn from the normal population that you consider with mean mu and variance sigma square. This is what the terminology it is going to be considered. So you have to understand this kind of set terminology. I repeat again, draw a random sample from the normal population. The sample is x1, x2 and so on, xn, random sample of size n from the normal population with mean mu and variance sigma square. This is what general assumption we consider, in which the four important points I consider, of course, the five important points, but alpha is fixed in advance, so therefore that is a fixed point, so we are not considering to explain here. So H0, the null hypothesis, the first point, null hypothesis H0, which we consider for single mean is mu is equal to mu naught. What is meant by mu naught? It is a specified value of mu, the population mean mu. So here we indicate population mean by mu, that is mu is equal to mu naught. That is the statement we can consider, the given sample has been drawn from the normal population, or else another statement, there is no significance difference between the sample mean and the population mean. What is sample mean? It is x bar. The mean is drawn, calculated for these values x1, x2, xn. It is x bar. It is the sample mean. Okay. The population mean is mu. And if you consider, is it visible? No. Come on. Yeah. So if we consider, this is the population mean mu, and we can set up another kind of hypothesis, as there is no significance difference between the sample mean and the population mean. That is also a statement we can give, right? That is the first one. And the second point is alternative hypothesis. We can formulate the alternative hypothesis, maybe mu not equal to mu naught, or mu greater than mu naught, or mu less than mu naught. These are the three kinds of alternative hypothesis we can formulate. The meaning of this is nothing but the sample mean is not drawn from the population mean. That is, the sample is not drawn from the population. Or else we can also consider that another statement, the sample mean, there is a significance difference. There is a clear significant difference between the sample mean and the population mean. This is the statement we can give in the alternative hypothesis. The third one, test statistic. That is our another important part, test statistic. So in the consideration of test statistic, it is very important that z is equal to, it is going to be calculated t minus expectation of t divided by standard error of t. For any kind of test statistic, for statistic t is going to be considered. So what is statistic t? It is to be relevant to consider a single mean. So you have to consider t is equal to sample mean x bar. T is equal to sample mean x bar. So for which you have to calculate expectation of x bar, standard error of x bar. As we know, if x1, x2, xn follows a, if x follows a normal distribution with mean mu and variance sigma square, then obviously x bar also, that is the sample mean also follows a normal distribution with mean mu and variance sigma square by n. This is what the fact we know. This is already proved fact. So therefore, I'm considering here. Therefore, expectation of x bar is equal to mu. X bar is an unbiased estimator of the population mean mu, sample mean. Sample mean is an unbiased estimator of population mean mu. We have proved this. And similarly, variance of x bar is equal to sigma square by n. That is what this distribution specifies. Now if you consider, this implies a standard error of x bar, that is standard deviation. Standard error is nothing but standard deviation. Standard error of x bar is equal to sigma by root n. So all the values we have calculated, expectation, standard error. So therefore, now we have to consider z. So z is equal to test statistic is equivalent to be x bar minus expectation of x bar divided by standard error of x bar, which follows n 0 1. So which implies this z is equivalent to be x bar minus expectation of x bar is mu divided by standard error of x bar is sigma by root n, which follows n 0 1. This is what the test statistic, right? So we have to consider test statistic under h naught. Test statistics under h naught you have to calculate now. Under the null hypothesis, test statistic is z is equal to x bar minus what is h naught? Mu. Mu is equal to mu naught. So h naught, mu is equal to mu naught, therefore x bar minus mu naught divided by sigma by root n. Okay, this is the test statistic under h naught, which follows n 0 1. This is what the standard test statistic is going to be considered. But here we have two cases. Consider case 1 and case 2. Come to case 1. Consider case 1. What is case 1? Case 1 is sigma is known. Sigma is known. Which means sigma is known, then the case where we use x bar minus mu naught divided by sigma by root n, which follows n 0 1. The same test statistics going to be considered. For example, case 2. Sigma is not known. If sigma is not specified, what we have to do? Then z is equal to, the sigma is going to be estimated by, then first of all I write, sigma is estimated by s. It is going to be considered, it is going to be estimated by s. So therefore, the test statistic z becomes x bar minus mu naught, the no difference here, divided by sigma, it is replaced with here the sigma. It is replaced with s divided by root n. The follows n 0 1. If sigma is not known, this is what the formula you have to use to calculate the test statistic, right? So now this is the part of test statistics. Now the fourth part is comparison and conclusion. So the comparison and conclusion. So this is the fourth part. The important part, and now you have to calculate whether whatever it is the case 1 or case 2, you have to calculate modulus of z, and you have to compare with the tabulated value at specified level of significance alpha, whether it is 5% or 1%. You have to consider this. If it is greater than, then this is significant value, this is calculated value, that is computed value. And if it is greater than z alpha, then h naught may be rejected. H naught may be rejected. And otherwise, that is, if modulus of z is less than or equal to z alpha, h naught is going to be accepted. Do you understand this? H naught is going to be accepted. This is what the procedure of test procedure for large sample test procedure for single mean. Large sample test procedure for single mean. Hope you understand. Thank you.